Well, I can't believe it, but it's time to review Creed 2. Here we go. Creed 2 stars Sylvester Stallone, Michael B. Jordan, Dolph Lundgren, Tessa Thompson, and is directed by Steven Caple Jr. What's up, guys? By far, one of the movies for this year that I was anticipating so much was Creed 2. I'm just, like you, like many people, I'm a massive Rocky fan. Grew up with the guy. He's just, Sylvester Stallone's a role model of mine. Rocky as a character is a role model of mine, as well as many people. But yeah, this movie looks, from the trailers, this looked like this was going to be completely epic. And I love that this was going to take place 30 some odd years after Rocky IV. You know, this Rocky IV is a big part of this movie. And looking forward to getting into this review. And before I jump into the plot synopsis, there's a lot about this movie that you could say, you could probably guess the outcome. I'll just say that, okay? So I'm not going to say that this is a spoiler review, but sometimes if I need to drive a point home that I'm trying to make, maybe I'll touch on some spoiler type stuff. But for the most part, I'm not going to like jump on stuff that's like, oh, I should not be telling you guys this. You know, I want you to find out this on your own. Like the final fight, I'm not going to tell you who won the final fight, of course. But, you know, like I said, if I do talk some spoilery type stuff, it'll be stuff that you're not going to be really that surprised by. But first, quick plot synopsis. This pretty much takes place after, I think a year after the first one, something like that. We all remember the fight with Ricky Conlan. And I forgot about this, actually. I just rewatched Creed recently. And, you know, Adonis did not win that fight, much like the very first Rocky. And so what this movie is, the beginning of this movie, Adonis has another fight. He wins the championship. And so this is really his comeuppance, you know, because he's still a really young boxer. So he's finding himself, finding his voice. And, you know, this is that crucial moment in a boxer's life where he has to prove himself. You know, he is the champion of the world, but he hasn't really earned that yet. And we might remember a little bit of this from Rocky III, where Rocky didn't really earn his championship after he beat Apollo Creed. There is a lot of similarities between Rocky II, Rocky III, and Rocky IV in this movie, kind of all rolled into one. You know, it's a fall and rise type of film, if you get my drift. And ultimately, it's a self-discovery type of movie. But this movie opens with Ivan and Victor Drago. That's the first thing you see in this movie, and boy, does it grab your attention. I'll go ahead and say this right now. Every time Ivan and Victor Drago were on screen, I was completely captivated. I really dug how the story unfolded with them, because they're not just superficial characters in this, like Ivan was in Rocky IV. No, they actually dig a little deeper, kind of give you their point of view of things. By the end of this movie, you actually feel for Victor Drago, which was a nice surprise. But, you know, they see that Adonis Creed is, you know, heavy into the boxing world now, and they want to face him. Victor Drago wants to face Adonis Creed. And boy, would this be a moneymaker, right? Like, you know, this Ivan Drago killed Adonis's father over 30 years ago. So this would be a huge moneymaker. So promoters would be all over this. But basically, that is this story in a nutshell. And let me just say, as far as like worthy opponents go, not since Ivan Drago in Rocky IV has there been such a worthy opponent. Victor Drago, this guy is just a complete monster. He is a beast. I mean, even looking at him standing toe-to-toe with Adonis, he towers over him, much like Ivan did over Rocky. And I'll just cut to the chase right now, jumping to the final fight between these two. It's legendary. It is probably one of the best final fights out of the whole Rocky franchise. Not just physically, not just how big he is, but just the way the fight is choreographed, the cinematography of the fight, just pretty much everything all around, the emotion involved in the fight. It is one of the better final fights, and it makes this movie as great as it is. And I guess I really wanted to foot stomp that first in this review, just so you guys know, if you're looking for a Rocky movie with a great final fight, look no further than Creed 2. One of the best final fights of the whole franchise. Can't foot stomp that enough. Also, Rocky in this movie. I actually prefer Rocky over him in Creed. If you remember in Creed, he had cancer. Stallone gave like an Oscar-worthy performance, won all kinds of awards for the movie. Really got down to the heart of who Rocky was as a character. This one, you still get a lot of that, but also you get more of Rocky as like a trainer and a coach, you know. And I love that at the beginning of this movie, he did not want Adonis to take this fight at all. He, you know, he talked to him about what he went through as a fighter against Ivan Drago, you know, saying that this guy broke things in me that ain't never been fixed. Stuff like that just really gave me chills. Eventually, Rocky does come around and he does train him. And let me just say, as far as training montages go, one of my favorite training montages. Very different, I think, than the previous montages. You know, I like when the Rocky movies kind of make their own in terms of the training montage, much like Rocky IV did. Rocky IV stands out amongst the pack just because of how different it is. You know, you got the Hearts on Fire song, you got the regular training montage. There's a point in this movie where Rocky tells Adonis, you are going to have to really find a part of yourself that you have never seen before. You know, to fight a fighter like Victor Drago, you have to be able to stand toe-to-toe to him. So he trains him in a very different way, you know, almost in like a pain type of way. It reminds me of The Dark Knight Rises a bit, how Bruce Wayne put himself through so much pain to train himself to take on Bane. That's kind of what Adonis does in this movie. Now, as far as acting goes, I have to give major props to Michael B. Jordan in this. I think he even tops himself in the first movie. There's quite a few scenes where he has to get really emotional in this movie. Probably more, much more than he did in the first movie, actually. Some might even say he turned on the waterworks a little bit too much, but given his circumstances in this movie, I buy it, you know. This is a guy facing a guy whose father killed his father, you know. So he's dealing with all these emotions, you know. He never got to meet his father in real life. So I think even more than the first movie, he's dealing with Apollo Creed, his father, and trying to cope with never getting to, you know, actually sitting in a room and talk to his father. That's gotta be tough. And then having to fight the son of the guy who killed his father. All that was great stuff in this. Now, as far as any cons, it does kind of drag in the middle, you know, much like Rocky II did. And Rocky II is like one of my favorites of the bunch. It's one of those that every time I watch it, I love it even more. But, you know, when I first watched it, yeah, there are some kind of dry spots. But then when you look back at it years later, all that stuff had to be there. You know, all that stuff of Rocky, like, coping with Adrian being in the hospital, it was necessary. So, and I think it's the same with this movie. It's very necessary. Your adrenaline is rushing watching this movie. You're wanting to get to that final fight, but you need that character building stuff to get to that. So I'll definitely excuse it. Also, it's directed very well by Steven Caple Jr. I think comparing it to Ryan Coogler is really just, you know, one of those next level directors. This is a director that really had a stamp on his movies. Steven Caple, I like the look of this movie so much. I think structurally, it could have been a little bit more tightened up than the first one. The first one had a really great flow to it. But still, I'm glad that it didn't copy the first movie. I'm glad that this one definitely has its own look to it. And it's one of those that I definitely can't wait to own on 4K. So overall, guys, I'm giving this a super high purchase worthy. I just saw this movie yesterday, so it's still kind of percolating, but yeah, it's definitely one of the better Rocky movies. I'm gonna be recording my Rocky ranking right after this. As far as where this one sets in the bunch, it could change down the line. So I'm kind of playing it safe, I guess, with that ranking. But yeah, look forward to that. Anyway, guys, what are your thoughts on Creed 2? Let me know down below in the comments. Words are hard. Also, be sure to come over to Killer Flicks, where we talk horror all day and every day, and on Fridays. We do Free Fall Fridays. Follow me at Drumdums on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Letterboxd, and now Stardust. If you like what I'm doing, hit that subscribe button. I'd really appreciate it. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and Drumdum out.